right. Hey, everyone. I am here with Ricardo from Mexico. Well, Ricardo, you got to say your last name because...
Sure. My last name is Carrillo. Ricardo Carrillo. Okay. Bye.
And you're a real estate agent in the Yucatan Peninsula of Mexico, which can you tell us like where that... I've heard of the Yucatan, but where exactly is it in relation like to the state?
Always they send me, where is Mérida, Yucatan? I say, well, do you know Cancun?
Yes.
I know Cancun. Well, it's really close to them.
Nice.
Yucatan is at the state and Mérida is the city. Mm-hmm. Mérida is a city that is growing a lot, very fast, a lot of investment. So it's a great place to be a realtor.
Yeah, awesome. And you said like a lot of people are moving there like every day because it's a very safe place to be. And just a lot of people... it's really a growing city right now and a growing state.
Yeah, as I tell you, 50 before the pandemic, 50 people, 50 families a month come here. So mm-hmm. we have a lot to offer, a lot of demand, a lot of work, and it's one of the safest cities, I think, in the world, Yucatan, Mérida.
Nice.
And it's really good because you can go outside, you can see what's happening. The feeling of the Mexican people are really, really good. We are good people, you know?
Yes, I love Mexico, but I was in Mexico City and it's like one of my favorite cities in the world. I even tried to learn Spanish a couple of times, but...
We can work on it.
Yeah, we'll work on it together. So we were talking about, there are some differences in how you get, in Mexico, it's not required to have a license. You just have to be able to sell. But the thing about salespeople is sometimes they feel like the relationship with the customer is over once they get the commission check. But you feel differently about that. What is your process? What do you do?
Completely true. I think when you have the process of buying, of selling something, mm-hmm. And you have someone of confidence, a realtor of confidence, I may say, You don't finish your job when you take your commission and whoa, that's it.
That's it.
Yeah. No, I think a plus, something you can give a little bit more to them is, okay, this customer buys me. I'm going to tell him when I go to the development, I'm mm-hmm. going to see how the construction is going. I'm going to record a video like, hey, man, this is your investment right now.
Yeah.
It's going great. You did a great investment. Because that you get a little friendly with it, you get a little more chit chat with it, you can take more of him, like what is the social circle he is. They can have more customers for you.
Right.
So I think getting that like continued process of growing with them and then delivering the product to them is something that it makes you special, right? It makes you special as a realtor because some people see realtors like a real serious people, real like, hey, do you want to buy this? Hey, do you want a quote? No.
Right.
Have
fun. And like what you're talking about is like, you're talking about building a relationship with them. And because you're building the relationship, you know them and you know that they want to know the process of like how, if they're doing a new build, like how is it going? And then you're right. Yeah. Once you deliver great service, then they will send you like more customers, which is that's easier than finding a new one.
Yeah, totally. Because when you do that and you don't stay like the realtor, just like they're gonna see it, your phone and go, oh, it's a realtor. I'm not gonna answer that.
Right.
I prefer to them like, hey, it's Ricardo. Hey man, how are you? Do you have a drink yesterday? What's up, man? Like getting that dynamic with it, you know? I like to be really dynamic with the customer because it gives him like, okay, this guy is okay. You know, I like talking to him, not only about the job.
But everything. Yeah.
Whatever you want. We can talk, you know? Yeah.
That's think though too, it like builds trust with the customer. And I think like, when they see you as somebody, it feels like you're listening to them and that you understand what they want and can help them better, you know, than somebody who is like too serious and not flexible. Yeah.
Totally, because we have to be serious in the business, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, don't get me wrong. There is people that are thinking about investing the money that they worked so hard to get.
Right.
So do we have to be really serious about it? But don't confuse that seriousness because there's still people that are like a little afraid of what they're doing.
Right.
So we have to be able to take it a little bit, to go around it a little bit, to talk.
Like make it not so stressful, really.
Yeah, totally. Yeah, yeah, not that stressful, because in this business, I think it gets really stressful in this moment. Like when you're done with the contract, the paper, they're like, wow, okay, right. they're scared.
Yeah, so
you
for
have
sure.
To be softly with them.
What are some of the things that you do once the whole project is done and the deal is done? How are you staying in touch with your clients or your past clients?
Well, I try to stay close with my clients via mail. Mm-hmm. You know, like the classical mail that you send, like, we have this new project, we don't have this.
Oh, but, just like an email, kind of?
Yeah, okay. But with my really, really close clients, I try to stay in touch. Like, also, like, if you come to Tulum, give me a call. I'm going to see you, because it's nothing much more
gratifying, you're right.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Like, sitting with a client that trusting you and buy you, I think I have to pay, right? Well, I know why you pay for me, I pay for you right now. Like that trust, that relationship, as you say, is really important to keep in touch with them.
Yeah.
Keep in touch with them, because they trust you for a big stuff.
Right.
They don't buy you a couple of dollars, they buy you something they can call home.
Right.
So that is really important.
I think so too. I think like keeping in touch with people either verbally or face to face, but definitely face to face, like spending time with people, then you can get to know them really well. And it's a good way to like get customers and referrals from them, because they do trust you.
Sure. And I think something that happens to all of us in the pandemic was that we don't have face-to-face anymore.
Right.
We are like connecting with people via WhatsApp, and that's so difficult.
Yes.
It's so difficult to connect with someone via a chat. You don't know how he's expressing the word.
Yes, exactly.
So that's difficult, because you're like, wow, is he being serious or he's being funny?
Right, what is the context? Yeah, definitely.
You don't know how to approach with them, and like, wow, do I send him a meme or not? What's next? Because it's difficult, but we are learning how to do it.
Yeah.
We are learning with a call, you can listen to his voice and say, okay, this is a serious customer. Okay, yes. This is a much more like curious customer. He only knows what is going on. So
right.
It's difficult now, because face-to-face, you can see his hands, you can see his movements, his eyes, but wow, it's difficult times.
It is difficult. It's so interesting to talk to real estate agents, not only like in the US, but also around the world, to see like what's different and what's the same, but definitely like communication and connecting with customers and just making it a relationship. It is a relationship-based business everywhere in the world. So it was really fun to talk to you.
Yeah, same. Awesome to talk to you.
And if people have a client that's maybe interested in investing in the Yucatan, or they have questions about investing there or want to move there, like what is the best way to get a hold of you?
Well, you can find me on my social media, as Ricardo Carrillo on Facebook. You can find me on my, I think I can leave you before the video, I can leave you my social and stuff.
Okay.
But yeah, I you don't have to come to me, you know? There's a lot of people coming here. There's a lot of information going on.
Yeah.
I think Yucatan is a really good place to invest right now. I think we are going very, very strong on the new era of the big city and a monopoly city, you know? So
there's a lot of growth and building happening there. Yeah.
We are going like this. Boom, boom. Yeah. Now we're going like this.
Oh.
Buildings. So I, as a Yucataner, I am a Yucateco, it's called here.
Okay.
I see it and like, wow, here used to be a park after, you know, and now it's a
really now it's like cool, a big building, yeah.
So yeah, this is awesome what's happening here because it's giving employment and economics and mm-hmm. investment and it's going great. I strongly advise to your people that come to Mérida and know Mérida, know why we are what we are. Mm-hmm. And yeah, we are gladly to receive them anything time you want.
Awesome. Well, I appreciate you being on. Thank you so much, Ricardo.
Thank you, Jennifer. See you.
Yeah.